As I stood outside the door of Richelieu's chambers, I could hardly believe my ears. A plot to kill the queen? It appeared I'd yet another mission before I could leave the palace. I drew back into the shadows and waited. After several minutes, the man addressed as Rochefort left the room. Then I saw his face, and my heart leapt into my throat. It was the dark man with a scar, the man who'd stolen my letter. This time he'd not escape me. He walked quickly down the corridor and started up the stairs towards the Queen's chambers. What was I to do? I was too far away to prevent his ascent. So I unsheathed my sword and threw it at him. It stuck, quivering in the wall. I rushed forward and leapt on him. We rolled down the stairs. He drew his sword. I knocked it from his hand. He ran back, took my sword from the wall and faced me. I picked his blade up from the floor and balanced it in my hand. At last, for my revenge, Argon. Up and down the stairs we fought, over the side, into room after room and out of them. Smashing over tables and chairs, we dashed them out of our way. Finally, I fought him step by step to the top of the stairway. Then, with a quick thrust, I locked his sword to his breast and forced him back over the edge of the balustrade. He struggled for a moment, lost his balance, and fell crashing over the side. Ah! He landed on the floor below on top of his sword. It slithered through his breast and came out through his back. Exhausted, I ran to his side. Yes, he was dead. And there on the floor beside him was a letter. I picked it up and slipped it into my glove. But the noise of our struggle, it attracted the guards. They surrounded me. I was under arrest for the murder of Rochefort, captain of Richelieu's guards. Richelieu demanded that I be tried immediately. The king himself entered the trial chambers. Richelieu began the prosecution.
Your Majesty, members of the court, as Prime Minister of France, I, Richelieu, demand that D'Artagnan be put to death for having ruthlessly murdered the captain of the guards, Henri de Rochefort.
Yes, sir.
Your Majesty well knows that dueling is forbidden in France, but these musketeers and their recruits do not obey our laws. They are little better than outlaws. Shall we permit our own guards' lives to be wasted in this manner?
One moment, Your Eminence.
What?
Before you condemn me further, I think it only fair to remind you that Monsieur Rochefort came to his end by your own order.
My order?
He was a traitor to the king and France, as Your Eminence must have known when you wrote this.
What have you there?
A letter. May I read it? It is by my order and for the good of the state that the bearer of this has done what he has done. It is signed, Richelieu.
But I mean to say, yes, of course. Your Majesty, we withdraw the charges against D'Artagnan.
So, I was freed. I suppose I should have been very happy, but I wasn't. You see, I hadn't seen or heard from my good friends, the Three Musketeers, since that night at the inn. And for all I knew, they were dead. I returned to Monsieur de Tréville's office with a heavy heart. But as I opened the door...
D'Artagnan!
Athos, Porthos, Aramis! You're saved, you're well!
Good! Nothing like a little lead to help the digestion.
Congratulations, D'Artagnan. Welcome to the Musketeers.
One for all.
And all for one.